I'm joined by Reed Gusiora. Reed is an assemblyman in the New Jersey legislature, and he is a proponent of preservation. He and I have collaborated over the past couple of years trying to get the message out and the word out to preserve this historic site. Reed, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Thank you for inviting me, Bill, and you've been doing a yeoman's job on the effort.
Thank you. I appreciate that, Reed. So talk to me about what we can do. So as you know, Mary Jacobson, the Superior Court judge in Mercer County, ruled against the Princeton Battlefields petition to stop the IAS, the Institute for Advanced Study. But it is pending an appeal, and I think Mary Jacobson did the right thing by at least stopping the construction and the development, but the Superior Court, or I'm sorry, the Appeals Court, drop that, essentially saying that they can put it back if they rule in their favor. What do you make of that, and what can we do?
Well, I think at this point, it should go through the courts, but also it should be in the hands of the people. I would encourage all your listeners to call the Institute today to tell them to do the right thing and stop the bulldozers.
Can you tweet that number? Because I'd love to get that number out there so people can talk.
I sure will. I would love to do that.
Yeah, and we'll retweet that and get that word out. What about the DEP? Any sense in calling Bob Martin? I mean, I don't understand.
I think all of the above, and I think well, I'll be writing a letter to Bob Martin today. I think he's a reasonable person. He lives in the Princeton area, and I think he gets it. So we'd like to see them to enforce the wetlands laws and put a stop there as well. But I think at this point, it's going to have to be a lot of public awareness. And in Princeton, there's a plethora of housing being built right now. There's plenty of places for the Institute's faculty to live around Princeton. It's in close proximity to the Institute. And I think it's just no reason to destroy a place of history, especially for future generations.
Do you think we've got a shot at Bob Martin stepping up? I mean, I agree with you. He's a local resident. He certainly understands. I mean, the DEP has been aggressive with preserving wetlands, with preserving open space. And we could argue all day long about how I think it's been a colossal waste of money in many towns on some of the open space taxpayer money that's been spent to buy up these farms to stop development. But that, you know, to me, that's a story for another day. These guys have been aggressive with it, though.
And I think this is another instance of patriotism. You know, talk about ISIS being able to recruit members. This battlefield is a way to recruit future generations to join the Marines, join the armed services, and be proud of our country. This was 10 days where George Washington was able to turn around the British. And yes, the 1st Marine Battalion came up with General Cadwalader, and their right flank was the one that stopped the British advance.
Yeah.
And it's probably most likely the place where the 1st U.S. Marine was killed, since the right flank went through the Institute lands.
Let me ask you this, Reed. Is there any possibility of the legislature acting at least on a recommendation? I mean, you guys pass all these resolutions all the time, congratulating people. So most of the time, the resolutions seem to sail through relatively easy. Just as a question, I can't imagine there are many legislators that wouldn't step up and say, yeah, how do you build houses where Washington won a crucial battle against the British?
I agree with you, and I'd be more than happy to introduce one. And if you look at other states like Virginia and Maryland, they have such a historical presence and a priority in keeping their history, both on the Civil War battlefields and Revolutionary. And I think New Jersey should do the same. We have enough development in the state, enough pavement, where this could be a great park.
Yeah.
And a learning center. So
I agree. You know, we were talking, Reed, you and I have talked about this before, and both being a part of Jerry Hurwitz's effort. I think Jerry has done a great job as head of the Princeton Battlefield Society pushing this. And he and I have talked, and I know you have too. There's an opportunity for a revenue generator with a visitor center there. I mean, there's a huge, huge missed opportunity right now that the literal crossroads of the turning point of the war for independence happened right here in Mercer County, New Jersey. It's amazing.
I know, and there's the grave of unknown soldiers that are buried. We have we added actually property off of 206,
mm-hmm.
and with the Institute lands, I think it's their time to be generous again and really create this battlefield. And again, it would be such a great learning center for residents of across the nation to come and learn about the Revolutionary War.
I agree. Well, if you can tweet out the phone number, I think you're right. I think the three-part plan is the Institute phone number. If they maybe if they get some pushback, feedback from the people who live here and appreciate American history, it might at least put a question in their mind. And then more importantly, I think also going after the DEP and talking to Bob Martin. I'll make sure his number gets out there. And then I really do, Reid, I got to tell you, I think that introducing a piece of legislation just as a question to the DEP, hey, guys, we want you to take a second look at this. It's not going to cost the taxpayers any money. We're not asking you to buy the land. Just take a look at it before this goes too far.
Yeah, and there's plenty of time for the Institute to build. Who builds in the winter? So this is
exactly.
A way of really pushing up the project. They can wait till spring. And
find another spot. Yeah. All right. Reid Gusciora, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Reid, always great to talk to you. If I don't talk to you before, you have a very Merry Christmas, and we'll certainly be talking soon.
You as well, Bill.
All right. Thanks
so much.
Okay. You bet. Bye.